students to my SST class. Let us continue the chapter Mughal Empire from the history side. In previous class, we have discussed the origin of Mughals, Mughal lineage, Mughal military campaigns, Mughal emperors, major campaigns and events. Let's start with the topic Mughal traditions of succession. Mughal didn't believe in the rule of primogeniture. So the question is, what is the meaning of primogeniture? A system where eldest son inherits his father's estate. Matlab ghar ke jo bade bete the usko hi pita ka property milta tha. Okay? Mughal believed in Mughal and Timuran custom of co-personary. Co-personary means division of property amongst all the son. Matlab pita ka jo property hai equally distribute ho jata tha sab bete ke beech pe. Let's move on to the next topic, and that is Mughal relations with other rulers. Mughals campaigned against other rulers. मतलब बहुत सारे rulers और kings जो मुगल supremacy को मानने से इनकार करता था, Mughals launched a various battle against them. Many rulers also joined Mughal voluntarily. बहुत सारे king जो खुद ही आके मुगल empire पे add हो जाते थे. Rajputs married their daughters into Mughal families. मतलब जो matrimonial relation था in between Rajput and Mughal. Also this relation was very very good. Some examples are there for that. The mother of Jahangir was a princess, daughter of Rajput, ruler of Amber. The mother of Shah Jahan was a Rathore princess, daughter of the Rajput ruler of Marwar. Rajput received high positions in Mughal court. Even defeated rulers were treated honorably by Mughals. Many defeated rulers were given their land, means Watan, back as assignment Watan Jagir. Okay, but some exceptional examples also were there, just like Sisodia Rajput. And Maharana Pratap was one of them. They refused to accept Mughal authority for a long time. Now, we are going to discuss our next topic, and that is administration of Mughal Empire. Under this topic, we will discuss Mansabdars, Jat and Zamindars. So, let's start with the first topic, and that is Mansabdars. So, the question is, who were Mansabdars? Mansabdars were those who joined Mughal service, enrolled themselves as Mansabdars. The term Mansabdars refers to an individual who holds a Mansab, meaning a position or rank. Mansabs were appointed from diverse background like Turkish, Irani, Rajput, Afghans, Marathas. Mansabdars was grading system used by the Mughals to fix rank, salary and military responsibility. Rank and salary were determined by a numerical value called jut. The higher the jut, the higher noble's position and salary. So, mansab means rank or position. Mansabdar ka rank or salary jut ke upar dependent tha. The higher the jut, the higher Mansabdar's position and salary. Now, my dear students, just look at the functions of Mansabdar. The Mansabdars were required to maintain a specific number of Sawar or cavalrymen to increase the military strength of the ruler. Cavalrymen means ghor Sawar. Cavalrymen were registered and horses were branded. Mansabdar received their salaries as revenue assignment called Jagir. Jagir means rent-free lands. These Jagirs were carefully assessed that their revenue were roughly equal to the salary of the Mansabdar. So, jo Mansabdar the, wo revenue means taxes collect karte the Jagir se. Aur Jagir se jo collect karte the taxes, usse hi wo soldier, uske andar jo soldier kaam karte the, usko payback karte the. But remember, Mughal jo aur bhi bade official the, wo bahut carefully assist karte the, jo revenue uthate the, wo jagir se, wo jyada na ho, wo mansabdar ke salary se. Now, our next topic is Jabt and Zamindar. Jabt was a revenue system under which each province was divided into revenue circles with its own schedule of revenue rates for individual crops. So, Jabt one kind of tax system hai, jahan pe jo province means chote chote area hai, usko divided kiya jata tha revenue circle pe for individual crops. Okay. Next one, Akbar revenue minister Todermal carried out a careful survey of crop yield for 10 years period. On the basis of this data, tax was fixed for each crop. The Mughals used the term Zamindars to describe all intermediaries, local headmen of villages or powerful chieftain. Functions of Zamindar, their function was to collect taxes from peasants, peasants means small farmer, and submit the same to the central government's revenue department. So my dear students, that's enough for today's class. We'll meet in our next class. Till now, bye. Happy learning. Take care.